life is full of challenges. It's never a straight line. There's always peaks and valleys.
We have a passion for real estate. We live it and we love it.
But what they do not see are the challenges us business owners go through.
Intact, California, Arizona, Texas, non-judicial zoning.
And that gave me the opportunity to get properties cheap, revitalize them, and provide housing for the people in the community that I grew up in.
You learn as you go, and you just have to be a solution specialist.
Hey, good morning, good morning, good morning. Great Saturday morning, actually it's almost afternoon. Just gonna check out one of the flips. I actually just got a call from the carpenter. Ran into an issue, so I'm gonna try to see if I can help solve whatever problem. So this is actually a flip that I'm doing. This is a big project where I'm building a large extension to the house. We're doing an addition to convert the house to about 3,500 square feet from originally 1,700 square feet. With an attached two-car garage. So this is a project that I started working on probably around in September. I think we got the permits, and we had to do the foundation, we had to add the addition. The goal for this was to get the outside all wrapped up and done by the end of November. City inspections are a week apart, and we had to make some changes in the drawings because we did some changes in the foundation, so that kind of knocked us off a bit. So I'm about 30 days behind on this project, and I'm trying to figure out ways every day of, you know, how I can catch up and, you know, get ahead two more weeks here and there. So I just got here. We're in the beginning stages. We're making a lot of progress. So far, we got the entire inside out down to the beam, and we removed all of the old siding from the property. We also demolished the front porch that was here. Everything is down to the beams. Looking good. We're now starting the excavation for the addition in the back also. They're telling me all the digging will be done by tomorrow, and then the foundation guy will come and do his thing. Let's look at the basement. Everything was demolished. All the rooms that were down here opened up. Got to remove an above ground tank. So all of the plumbing, all of the old gas pipes, all of that stuff is out clean. Get a look at the second floor. Everything is down to the studs. Did notice in the bathroom there was some leakage from the shower. For like years it's been happening inside the wall. So when we took the exterior apart, the siding, and open these walls up, this is what we found. So it's a good thing that we actually gutted this out, because this would have been a major problem. So I'm excited to see if we can push this project along a little faster to get to that end goal. This is the restoration that I'm doing in Montclair. And this is the one we're doing the addition on. So I came to check to see how far in the process these guys are, how much progress are they making. So we're putting 1,800 square feet. As you can see, we're extending the back of this project all the way here. We're putting an attached two-car garage. So I'm actually here to meet with my plumber. We're trying to figure out, again, we're behind on this project. We're trying to figure out ways of catching up. The plumber is actually just getting started, so we're gonna just go over a couple of things to make sure we're on track and figure out how we can get ahead. So the last time I was here, we didn't have all the windows. Siding wasn't done, so this is coming out pretty nice. Just stopping by to see how far these guys got in the project. We're doing everything except for the front, because I'm waiting for an approval on the variance.
before I dig the foundation. The porch, I wanted to make a little wider instead of having it the way it was here. We're gonna extend the porch and create a different effect on that. All the windows are in. I did the side in the garage, so I just have to do this side now. And this is like a mud room going into the stairs, going into the two-car garage. So it looks like HVAC guy is pretty much done with all the HVAC. So now we're just gonna get the plumb electrician here. We got an office slash bedroom on this floor over here. This looks beautiful. This is the open floor. It's dining room, living room, and kitchen.
You guys were really impressed by what we did here so far. So this is the garage, the two-car garage that's built from the ground. This house had an addition on. And now we're at a point where we're halfway there. I mean, we got the rough plumbing, rough electrical, rough HVAC. Let me give you the layout of this. So this is the kitchen. This is the bathroom. This is the closet. Gotta check and see again. This is a nook, what we call a nook. So from the kitchen, you can come over. There's gonna be a table here. You can have breakfast. You can look out the window. You can actually go off the deck here. Now let's take a look upstairs. Come to the second floor, we get a nice long hallway. Now we're gonna go out to bedroom number two. This is bedroom number two. Bedroom number two steps in. They have a nice closet here. It's gonna be a double door closet here. Very important, guys. When you do an addition, you see the size of this window? That's an egress window. And guess what this room is? This room is the master bedroom. Plenty of light. Right off the bat, with casement windows. And that just basically means the windows roll out, right? This master bedroom also has a deck. So it's a sliding glass door, and they can go onto the deck and relax off their master bedroom. The master bedroom has a huge walk-in closet. This is the master bathroom. The master bathroom has a stand-up shower, a freestanding tub, a 60-inch or 72-inch, maybe 60-inch double sink, and a toilet. And the master bathroom has its own linen closet for shelves that we're gonna put here for towels and washcloths. So yeah, this is all the master bedroom. Let's go to the third floor. Some people will call it playroom or living room for the third floor, because the third floor has its own bedroom as well. So you come to the third floor, they have a storage closet here. The third floor has its own bathroom. Nice large bathroom where you come in, stand-up shower, tub, toilet, sink, single sink, and a lot of space in the bathroom over here. The third floor also has another bedroom. Closet, nice size bedroom. Let's go check out the basement. The basement has its own bedroom here. Nice spacious bedroom in the basement. So I just gave you a quick walkthrough, guys. Hope you guys got some value from it. This is gonna be a nice, 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 nice house. We got a lot of work to do here. Show them what the front of the house looks like. You're sitting in your kitchen, imagine. This is your view from the front of your house. This is beautiful, right? It's all open space. Hope you guys got a lot of value from this. I'll keep you guys updated where we are in the process. So a couple of things here that was very challenging is that we had to swap a couple of windows, and then I just realized from going through final inspections here that the front bedroom on the left-hand right-hand side of the house needs an egress window So now I have to change all four windows to casement windows so they have match. So now my challenge here is, I got the siding already done. Now I got to rip out four windows, reinstall them, and come back and do the siding. So not only is it gonna cost me money, it's gonna cost me time. But these are the challenges that causes delays. Why is that important? Because now I have to pay more taxes, more interest to investors, more holding costs, period, which digs into my profit, right? So not only is it a waste of my time, it's cutting into my bottom line. I just rhyme. You like that? There's another challenge that we have with the property. It is electric.
Oh,
the stove is electric.
I just fixed it.
Yeah. All right. It's electric. I wanted to tell you that because Greg was telling me they no longer make them in gas, they make them all electric. And the architect put a gas stove inside of here.
So, you know what?
So we have a gas stove top. It's a six burner and a griddle top. But over here, we have an oven that's going in a cabinet and it's electric.